Thank you for visiting the NSA Georgia website. I'm Diane Bogino. Our guest today is Lou Heckler, CSP, CPAE. Lou is a seasoned broadcaster, educator, and a motivational and leadership speaker who covers customer service, being engaged at work, management, and peak performance. Not only does Lou have 34 years experience as a professional speaker, he also has 15 years of experience in television. So Lou can kick off your meeting, attend the rest of the sessions, take notes, and then provide your attendees with a humorous and poignant summary at the close of the event. Since he has also conducted more than 2,000 live television interviews, he can also serve as an interviewer up on the stage if you have an executive or other speaker who is more comfortable answering questions than going it alone. Lou, thanks so much for being on the show tonight.
Oh, delighted.
Good to see you again.
Thanks, nice to see you.
Lou, you talk about the fact that people are electronically engaged, but they're not truly, truly engaged with each other. How can they become more engaged, and why would that be important?
Well, I just think there's no substitute for face-to-face, you know, and I have this story I tell about a nephew of ours who works with young people, and he said to this one young boy who was kind of lonely or seemed lonely, he said, "Don't you have any friends?" And the kid said, "Oh, no, I have 1,232 or something like that." And he knew they were Facebook friends, but he said, "Well, how many of them do you actually know?" And the boy went, "Oh." And I think three things come to my mind that organizations can do to help their people feel more connected or engaged. One is purpose. Make people really know what the real purpose is of the business. Sometimes we get confused with the logistics and don't really know what the purpose is. The second is performance. You know, what are we expecting each day from each person? And then the third thing is naturally people. Do you really have the right people in the right job? Those three things, I think, help people feel more engaged.
Right, right. And you have, for 30 years, studied peak performers and leadership specialists.
Yeah.
Have you found anything that these folks might have in common with each other?
You know, one of the things I think they have in common is they are disgruntled people. In other words, they're never satisfied with the way things are now. They always have a vision of something bigger. But most importantly, they take that vision and break it down into a real mission. What do we need to do today to make this happen? And then they really celebrate that with the passion they have for what they do. So it's pretty much a vision, mission, passion kind of thing.
Ah, yes. And you talk about, or you say that even ordinary people can do extraordinary things, and I'm sure you're going to give us the secret formula for that, right?
Yeah, I wish there were a secret formula. I really think it's finding what your natural gift is. And I truly believe every person is gifted in some way. And it may not be that you can sing opera or that you can be a famous skateboarder or whatever, but there's always something you can do. And what I suggest to people is, you know, find the thing that you feel so natural when you do it. I have a young friend who is a very virtuoso piano player. And I said to him one time, "Do you remember what it felt like the first time you put your hands on a piano keyboard?" And he thought for a minute, and he answered with one word. He said, "Right." And so if you can find a job or a hobby or anything where it feels absolutely right, then I think you'll do extraordinary things.
Right. Now, when you talk about customer service, you say there are three main elements that for good customer service. Tell us what those are.
Well, in my experience, number one, it's, first of all, having a great product or service to offer. I mean, you have to have something that the public wants.
Right, right.
Number two, you have to get people engaged in the job who really believe in that, in what that product is. And it doesn't matter whether it's something fancy, if it's artwork or whether it's hardware or whether it's plumbing supplies. And then the third thing is, I think you really have to get inside the head of who your customers are. You know, what is it that you can offer them that they maybe can't get anywhere else? And that's the hardest part, because so many things that we offer today are offered by 10 other people, 18
right.
other businesses, 55 other places,
right.
or online.
Mm-hmm.
So what can you do so that when they think of that product or service, they come to you and go, I want to connect with you.
That's right. What is the one thing that you think business people can do to grow their business this year?
Boy, that's a great question. In my mind, it's to go back to the basics. It's just to say, you know, what is it that got this business going in the first place? And how can we simply in small increments, make that better and better and better every day. I think about the Disney Company. They discovered that the people at Disney parks, it's amazing that they studied this, would walk 26 steps. That was the most steps they'd walk to find a trash can. So there's no place in the Disney parks where you have to walk more than 26 steps to get to a trash can. So what I would say is, in every business, what's your version of the 26 steps? What are the basic things that you can do to make sure that you're really dotting all the I's and crossing all the T's like they do at the Disney parks? When you think about Disney, you think people, I ask people, what's, you've been to the parks, oh sure, what's the word you think of? And it's not fantasy and it's not playfulness, it's clean. 26 steps.
That's right, yes. Speaking of business people, you have coached over 250 speaking professionals. What is it that you coach these people to do?
Well, it really varies from person to person. One of the main things I try to help them do is to find the stories that they can use to really enliven their speech. People love to hear stories. And one of my mentors said to me, adults don't need to be taught, they just need to be reminded. And I think what stories do is they set off echoes in our head, and a good story that illustrates a point helps people to go, right, my dad used to say that, or my pastor, my scoutmaster, my coach, somebody. And you sort of remind them that they already know what's there. A lot of people who come are seminar leaders, and they want to be keynoters, so that's right. Another area.
Right.
And then I coach a lot of just business people who simply want to be able to connect more fully with their audiences. And we try to help them figure out some ways to do that.
Right. Great. Luz, thank you so much for being with us tonight. We
My
really
pleasure.
Appreciate your time.
My pleasure.
We've been speaking with Lou Heckler, CSP, CPAE. Thank you for visiting the NSA Georgia website. I'm Diane Bogino. Stay tuned because we'll be bringing you more great speakers from NSA.